오늘 그 2부는 중대원 헌신예배입니다. 기강예배.
The second worship service is given as the
opening worship service for the church officer graduate school. 붙잡는 시간입니다.
In other words, it's a time for all the church officers who are attending the graduate school giving this opening worship service.
저는 그 어릴 때 전도를 제대로 하는 가르치는 목사님을 본 적이 없었어요.
When I was young, I did not see any pastor who correctly taught me how to evangelize.
전도를 해야 되겠다는 생각은 들었는데 배워야 되겠는데 잘 배울 수가 없었어요.
Although I had this thought that I need to evangelize and I need to learn, but there was no way for me to learn from anyone.
결론 내리기를 내가 해야 되겠다 하는 생각을 했어요.
That is why I came to this conclusion. I need to do it myself.
뭐 없으니까.
Because it was not available.
그래서 나라도 해야 되겠다 하니까 성경에서 이렇게 발견되기 시작했어요.
And when I resolved that I need to do it myself, I was able to find all these in the Bible.
그리고 실제로 지금 가이오 같은 이런 브리스가 부부 같은 자도 사실은 제가 사는 동안에는 본 적이 없어요.
And in fact, you know, these examples, it's like Gaius, Priscilla's couple, I have not met with anybody who are like them.
저는 보지를 못했어요.
And once I see them, I will be able to learn from them, but I had not met with anybody like them.
역사에서 있었던 인물들을 찾아서 볼 수밖에 없잖아요.
That's why I had no choice but to research all these, you know, historical figures and learn from them.
기도했던 그 록펠러라든지 와나메이커의 사람들 보면서요, 저런 중직자면은 교회를 살릴 수 있겠다 그런 생각을 하기도 했습니다.
And by researching about Rockefeller and Wanamaker, I realized that if I were had all these church officers like them, we would be able to save the church.
오늘 메시지 듣고 그런 사람이 되는 시작을 하시기 바랍니다.
All of you church officers, as you listen to this message, may it be that start for you to become such church officers.
중직자의 길.
The church officer's way.
사도행전 17장을 일부에서 오늘 메시지를 확인했는데 여기서는 6절 하나만 붙잡으면 되겠습니다.
During the first word of service, we read the scripture from Acts chapter 17 and just need to hold on to one verse, verse 6.
야손 같은 인물 하나 나오면요. 아주 중요한 대사로니까 살아나요.
With one individual, Jason, also we will see the revival of the entire region of Thessalonica.
이 데살로니카는 로마를 통하는 유일한 고속도로가 있는 지역입니다.
And Thessalonica was a region that had the highway that would lead to Rome.
그게 하나님이 굉장히 중요하게 본 거죠.
And God considered that to be very important.
이게 우리 중직자분들이 살아나면 사실은 바울이 전도하는데 전혀 지장을 안 받아서 왜냐 든든한 중직자들이 있으니까.
That is why when you church officers are revived, it was so much of a sturdy background for support for Paul because he had all these great church officers who supported him.
아니 브리스가 부부는 돈 벌어가지고 전부 성경에 다 가져갔다니까.
Priscilla and Aquila, the couple, they earned so much money and then they gave all of that for missions.
돈이 뭐 많이 쓴지 모르겠습니다만 어쨌든 가이오는 모든 전도자의 식중이 됐어요.
And Gaius, I'm not sure whether he was a wealthy man, but he became a host for all the evangelists.
지금도 이런 중직자가 나와야 됩니다. 아니 목회자가 마음껏 전도 선교할 수 있어야 되지. 그리고 세계복음 할 수 있어야 되는 거 아닙니까?
We need to have such church officers. We need to help all of our pastors to be able to evangelize and carry out the missions to the fullest. So what can we do?
먼저 꼭 기억하셔야 됩니다.
You need to first remember this.
이걸로 끝입니다.
It's
기억하셔야 돼요.
All done with this, so you need to remember.
여러분은 복음을 받았기 때문에
because you receive the gospel.
기도가 뭔가 알면 됩니다.
Just know what prayer is all about.
기도 응답 받으면 뭐든지 할 수 있잖아요.
Once you receive prayer answers, you can do everything.
안 하면은 죽는 겁니다.
If you don't pray, you will die.
기도는 호흡입니다.
Because prayer is
breathing. 죽어요.
If you don't breathe, you will die.
그래서 기도를 실제 모르기 때문에 영적인 거는 죽어 있는 거예요.
And although you may be physically breathing, but spiritually, if you don't pray, you are dead.
말하자면 우리가 이게 폐가 망가지면 호흡을 못 하잖아요.
If our lungs are damaged, we cannot breathe properly.
그런데 육신적인 얘기고 실제 기도를 모르면은 영적으로 호흡이 안 되기 때문에 죽는 거란 말이에요.
And that's the physical aspects of ourselves. But however, if you do not pray, that means spiritually we cannot breathe, which means we have no choice but to die.
24 뿌리면 다 돼요.
So all it takes is doing 24 hours by holding on to important covenant.
24입니다.
And there's one way for you. Only one way for you to receive answers 24 hours.
초대교회 마가다락방 교회는 왜 이겼느냐? 24.
How was the early church in Marks of Perum able to overcome because they did 24 hours?
그 어머니가 얘기했잖아요.
Rockefeller, great individual, came forth and his mother said this.
너는 다른 기도할 거 없어.
You don't need to pray for anything else.
너는 돈을 벌었어. 교회 헌금 많이 하는 그게 최고야.
Earn lots of money and gave them all as offering to the church because you're in a business person. That's all you need to pray for. 24 hours.
교회 뭐 일 같은 거 하려 하지 말아요. 어머니 그걸 가르쳤어.
His mother taught him, don't even try to work. Just give lots of offering because that's what it means to be an entrepreneur, a businessman.
사람 말 듣지 말.
Don't listen to other people's words.
그냥 기도하고 말씀 붙잡고 네 경제가 세계 보험하도록 그거만 기도해.
Just pray and just hold on to God's word and really pray yet that your economy will be used for world missions.
하루 종일 메시지부터 예배 전에도 미리 가서 기도하고 그 은혜 잡고 기도하면 돼.
All day long, hold on to the word and go to the worship service 1 hour early and all day long pray for that.
겁니다.
And his mother taught him properly.
이게 기도입니다.
That's what prayer is.
그러면요, 아무리 머리 나쁜 사람도 24 하는 사람은 못 이겨.
Even if that a person may be so foolish that nobody else can overcome that person who can do 24 hours. Just hold on to one thing and do 24 hours.
그게 진짜면 역사를 하셔.
If that is true, then works are bound to arise. That is prayer.
그러면 반드시 이 일이 일어나.
Then absolutely 25 hours will arise.
저기 기도 응답입니다.
That is prayer answer.
그러면 영원히 남아.
Then it will leave behind the eternity, the answer of eternity. That's what it is. That's what you need to teach. And all of you church officers, you need to do it this way. You don't need to do anything that's complicated.
여러분이 구원받았기 때문에 두 번, 세 번 받을 것도 없고 끝났고 그다음에 여러분의 업이 세계 복음화에 초점 맞춰 24에 보면 돼요.
And because you are saved, you don't need to receive salvation a second time or the third time. And because of your occupation, really focus on it 24 hours so that it will be used for world evangelization.
예수님이 이렇게 말씀하셨어요.
And this is what Jesus said.
너희는 그의 나라와 그의 의를 구하라. 그리하면 모든 것을 너희에게 더하여 주시리라.
Seek first God's kingdom and his righteousness and all these things will be added unto you as well.
그래서 24 이게 답입니다.
24 hours that is the answer.
기도예요.
That is prayer.
그래서 여러분이 이 마음속에 진짜 들어 있는 건 24 돼요.
And what is really embraced in your heart will become 24 hours.
그 마약 중독된 사람 마약 24잖아요.
And a drug addict will do drugs 24 hours.
24시간 마약 안 해도 24시간 생각하고 있다니까요.
Even if the person is not actually using drugs, but the person is thinking about drugs 24 hours.
24. 틈나면 해요 이제.
Gambling 24 hours, whenever he has a chance, he will do gambling.
길이 열려.
And all the doors will open up towards that.
24는 무서운 겁니다.
24 hours is such a fearsome thing.
마약 24는 어디서든지 마약 구합니다.
A person who is addicted to drugs 24 hours will do drugs wherever he person would be. And if you do prayer 24 hours, everything will be finished.
그러면 이 어마어마한 기도의 내용 뭐죠?
Then what is the content of this tremendous prayer?
내용이 있을 거 아니에요.
There must be the content for this prayer.
실망대.
Seven partisans.
한 단어는 뭡니까? 하나님 나라와 그 일.
What is it in one word? God's kingdom and his righteousness.
그럼 거기를 그걸 가잖아요. 진료죠.
Then you're going on that journey, seven journeys.
군데군데 절대망대가 서겠죠?
And in every place, partisans will be raised.
진리정표.
Seven guideposts.
내용입니다.
That is the content.
말하면 하나님 나라의 일.
In one word, is the works pertaining to God's kingdom.
쉽게 말하면 보좌와 그 응답.
It is the throne and the answers.
예수님이 설명했어요.
That's what Jesus explained.
기도해야 될 급한 게 하나 있어요.
There's an urgent matter that we need to pray for.
고린도서 10장 1절에서 5절.
It is 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verses 1 through 5.
틀린 망대가 만들어져 있다니까.
Incorrect partisans are established.
그거 있으면 죽어도 응답 안 되는 거예요.
And when you still have them, even if you pray so much,
망대가 더 커.
And you see that the partisan of unbelief is greater, then what's going to happen? You cannot receive answers.
상처의 망대가 더 커.
That the partisan of scars is much greater.
완전히 원망할 수 있게 망대밖에 없어.
The partisan that causes you to complain. Then it's impossible.
그 망대를 무너뜨려.
You need to crumble down all these partisans with God's word.
그다음에 중요한 기도하는 이 시간표를 알아야 돼요.
And you need to understand this important time schedule of prayer.
무슨 시간표 말입니까?
What kind of time schedule?
누림.
Enjoyment.
기다림.
Waiting.
도전.
And challenging.
시간표입니다.
That is the time schedule.
자꾸 이렇게 불신자 습관이 돼가지고 무조건 하려는데 아닙니다. 언약 붙잡고 기다리는 거.
And people have this nature of an unbelief and try to just do things on their own, but you need to hold on to the covenant and wait.
하나님 나라의 일이 일어나도록 기다리는 겁니다.
You need to wait so that works of God's kingdom can arise.
그때부터 땅끝이 보입니다. 도전.
From then on, you will see the ends of the earth, then challenge.
이걸 놓고 계속 또 24로 들어가.
And again, you go back to 24 hours and continuously doing
여러분이
this.
여러분이 어마어마한 건강도 회복되기 시작할 겁니다.
Then amazing health will be restored in you.
진짜 기도하면 건강도 회복돼요.
If you truly pray, even health will be restored.
진짜 기도하면 여러분은 이 영도 살고 몸도 육도 다 살기 때문에요. 암도 이길 수 있어요.
If you truly pray, your body, your mind, every aspect of your health will be restored.
기도.
That's why even cancer will be cured. That's why pray 24 hours.
그래서 언약을 딱 잡고 우리 중위자분들이 시작해야 됩니다.
That is why firmly holding on to the covenant, all of you church officers need to begin anew.
기준이 있습니다.
There's a standard.
나의 업과 내가 사는 사회과 교회가 거기에 망대가 아니고 절대 망대가 써야 돼.
That we need to raise the absolute partisan, not just a partisan in my occupation and the church.
절대 계획이 보이죠.
Then you'll be able to see all the answers continuously coming and you'll be able to see the absolute plan and absolute covenant. Then you will go on this absolute journey. And there's an absolute goal.
절대 응답 옵니다.
Then absolute answers will come.
이렇게 되는 거예요.
That's what it will do. And that's why do not lose hold of this.
방법 뭡니까?
And what is the method?
사실상 여러분 눈 딱 떴을 때 가장 생각나는 게 뭡니까?
What is the very first thing that comes across your mind when you open your eyes
네,
in the morning?
눈 떴을 때 기도가 시작돼야 돼.
As soon as you open your eyes, you need to begin praying.
여러분 눈을 감고 잠들 때 무슨 생각하고 잡니까?
And as you close your eyes to fall asleep, what do you think?
그때 기도가 나와야 돼. 이거.
That's when you need to pray this.
그리고 사람 만나거나 일 만나거나 사람 소리 들을 때 뭐 해야 됩니까?
And when you hear from people, when you interact with people, when you talk to people, what do you need to do?
그걸 기도로 바꿔야 돼.
Convert all of that into prayer.
그걸 보고 삼집중.
We call that three concentrations.
모든 곳에는 문제 있습니다.
Everywhere you will see problems.
문제에 빠지면 죽어 답을 찾아.
You will die if you plunge into problems. Seek out God's answers.
모든 갈등은 내가 갱신하면 돼.
In every conflict, you need to renew.
모든 위기는 기회입니다.
Every crisis is an opportunity.
사망다.
Three answers.
그렇죠?
Isn't that so?
이 부분이 완전히 이 지금 나에게 플랫폼이 돼.
And that must become my platform.
그러면 뭐 파수망대 안테나 서게 되죠.
Then watchtower and antenna will be established.
이걸 보고 3 세팅이 돼.
We call this three settings.
그러면 뭡니까?
And then
남길 것 하나 있어요.
There are things that you need to leave behind.
2, 3, 7, 5천 종족 살기 위해서 남길 게 있단 말이에요.
In order to save the 2, 3, 7 nations and 5,000 tribes, you need to leave behind the three courtyards.
다민족의 뜰.
The courtyard of Gentiles.
기도의 뜰.
The courtyard of prayer.
아이들의 뜰.
The courtyard for children.
이걸로 끝입니다.
And that's it.
초대교회가 이 기도인 겁니다.
And this is what the early church prayed for. And the church officers prayed for this. They did not just pray, they did 24 hours. What about the rest? God will provide everything.
뭐 어떤 거는 여러분이 어려움 와도 괜찮아요.
And sometimes even if hardships come, it's all right.
놓치면 안 됩니다.
So just don't lose hold of this.
그러면 이렇게 하면은 가장 먼저 어떤 응답이 옵니까?
Then, as introduction, if you do this, what is the very first answer that will come?
눈에 안 보이는 망대가 먼저 생겨요.
The invisible partisan will be raised, invisible to our eyes.
눈에 안 보이는 망대가 뭡니까?
What is this invisible partisan?
영적으로 눈에 안 보입니다. 여기 서밋이 딱 돼요.
Spiritually, it is invisible. You become the spiritual summit.
이 축복을 누리시더니 우리 장로님들이 가는 곳에 영적인 이 리더가 돼버려.
And because you're enjoying this prayer, all of you elders, wherever you go, you become the spiritual leader.
여기에 따라서 나오는 사업이라야 기능 서밋이 되는 거예요.
And only when the business comes out from being the spiritual summit, then you become the skill summit.
문화 서밋이 돼.
And you leave behind the masterpiece, you will become the cultural summit.
이때부터 오는 게 뭡니까?
And what comes from here?
놀라운 게 오는 겁니다.
Something amazing comes forth.
With Emmanuel oneness라는 시스템이 딱 만들어져.
You will establish the system of with Emmanuel and oneness.
오직 유일성 재창조의 시스템이 딱 만들어져.
And you also have the system of only uniqueness and recreation.
눈이 안 보여. 이거부터 만들어져야 되는 겁니다.
Unseen to our eyes, these must be raised first. They're invisible.
그래서 믿음은 바라는 것들의 실상이요 보지 못하는 것의 증거니.
That is why faith is being sure of what you hope for and being certain of what you do not see. And it is what it's being certain of what you do not see.
신 없어요. 그건 우상이에요.
And if there is a God that is visible, that would be an idol.
하나님 눈에 안 보이는 겁니다.
God is invisible.
그게 진짜예요.
That is true.
우리의 영혼 눈에 안 보이죠. 그게 진짜 나라니까.
Our soul and spirit, they're invisible.
그렇죠.
And that's our true selves.
그렇듯이 이거부터 먼저 딱 만들어요.
Likewise, we need to establish this invisible partisan first.
이걸 보고 플랫폼.
And we call this the platform.
파수망대 이제 다른 사람 살릴 수 있으니까.
And we call this as a watchtower because we can save other people.
전 세계가 통해 안테나.
And we can connect with all the rest of the world antenna.
실제 여러분 휴대폰 하나 집 안에 들어가면 전 세계 통합니다.
And because you have this your smartphone and with this you can connect with the rest of the world.
이 역사 일어나는 겁니다.
And likewise, we can have all these works taking
자,
place.
자 그러면 이제 우리 중인자 통해서.
That is why through our church officers.
뭐가 일어납니까?
What is going to take place?
이로만 가지게 됩니다. 하나님의 말씀이 성취되기 시작.
You will go on this way of fulfillment of God's word.
드디어 이 이후에 뭔 일이 벌어졌습니까?
And then after that, do you know what happened?
중직자들이 위기 때 모였는데 이게 세계 바꾸는 교회가 됐어요.
When all the church officers gathered together in the midst of crisis, this turned into the church that saved the entire world.
시험에 빠지잖아요. 아닙니다. 이때 모여서 기도했는데 교회를 세우는데 이게 세계복음하는 교회.
It was a time that everybody fell into trials and temptations. However, when all the church officers gathered together, it established a church that was saving the entire world.
하나님의 최고 소원인 이 교회에서 선교사를 파송해요.
And from this church that God desired the most, they commissioned out the missionaries for the first time.
그냥 오고 가는 한참 보이지만은 이게 영원한 것으로 바뀌어요.
And you may think that missions is something that people just go
그렇죠?
back and forth. However, it will become the everlasting answer.
이 사람들 통해 가지고 마게도냐로.
And with this people, they went into Macedonia.
성취되고
있어요. Undoubtedly, it is being fulfilled, no matter what other people say.
이 갔더니 무슨 일이 났으면 그럼 뭐 말 다 안 해도 아시겠지.
And without further explanation, you know what took place.
데살로니카로.
The most important region, Thessalonica.
말씀이 성취되나.
And that's how you see the progression of the fulfillment of God's word.
아주 중요한 우상 국가라고 하면 고린도로.
And the most idolatrous region to the place of Corinth.
여기에 하나님이 브리스가 부부를 붙인 겁니다.
And God attached Priscilla's couple to that region.
로마로.
And to Rome.
이렇게 연결하고 있어요.
That's how God's word is being fulfilled.
이 로마까지 그냥 어떻게 됩니까?
And all the way to this Rome.
바오라 두려워 말라 가이사 앞에 서야 하리라.
God said to Paul, do not fear,
그렇습니다.
you must stand trial before Caesar.
절대 바뀌지 않습니다.
It will not ever change.
그 누가 뭐래도 바꿀 수 없습니다.
No matter what other people say, it is
똑같습니다.
unchanging. It is the same even right now.
거예요.
You are standing in this line.
가장 뭐부터 나와야 되냐? 감사부터 나와야
What do you need to have first? Thanksgiving.
진정한 감사부터 나와요.
You need to have this true, genuine thanksgiving.
생각해도 감사. 어떻게 이렇게 우리가 말해 하나님 은혜로 구원받고 이 속에 있나 이 말이요.
And the more you think about it, how on earth that by God's grace that we can stand in this line of world evangelization.
사람 죽이고 멸망받는 속에 있는 사람 얼마나 많습니까? 하나님 우리 이 속에 있게 만들어.
And while there are so many other people who are in this line of destruction and killing other people, we are in this line of the fulfillment of the word.
이때부터 이제 가만히 있어도 이제 응답 오기 때문에.
And from this point on,
좀 준비해야 되겠죠.
Just by being still, you can still receive answers. That's why prepare your vessel a little bit.
여러분 집에
At your home, what's going to take place?
그걸 준비해야 돼요. 교회.
And also in the church.
여러분의 업에.
In your occupation.
이런 세 번 딱 옵니다.
These three things will come.
가장 중요한 여러분 집에 이제는 집이 미션 홈이 되는
At your home, it will become a mission home.
집 자체가 사람 살린 집.
Your home in and of itself will become a place of saving other people.
여러분 집을 통해서 후대들이 살아나.
And through your home, your next generation posterity will be restored. It will become an RUTC.
여러분의 집과 여러분 있는 직장과 사업처가 지교회가 되는 거예요.
And where your home is, your occupation, everything will become the regional church. These three aspects are very important about your home. So these works have no choice but to arise.
자, 교회에서. 중직자들 어떤 역할을 하게 되느냐?
What kind of role would the church officers do in the church?
이방인의 딸.
The courtyard of the Gentile.
다민족이 몰려오기 시작할 건데요. 다민족의 가장 중요한 게 뭔지 압니까?
All the multi-ethnic people will come to our church, but do you know what is most important for them?
어디서 자야 되느냐입니다.
Where are they going to stay?
그래서 저는 앞으로 조금 있으면 응답 오면요. 도시에다가 다민족 숙소 만들 겁니다.
That's why when we receive the answer, we're going to make all these lodging places for the multi-ethnic people to come and stay. This is very important.
여러분들이 초대교회는 어떻게 했냐? 개인 집에 다 데리고 있어요.
And do you know what happened during the early church, you know, people? They invited the multi-ethnic people to their homes because at the time they would get arrested. So the early church, it was they were unstoppable.
중요합니다.
This is very important, the lodging area.
교회는 막상 기도할 데가 없어요. 기도했더니 있어요.
And somehow there's no place for us to pray in the church. That's why we need the courtyard of prayer.
이게 가장 중요한 건 뭡니까?
Do you know what is the most important aspect of this?
치유입니다.
Is healing.
부흥되지 말아도 돼요.
And without people trying to do growth and revival,
치유될 수 있다. 올 수밖에 없어요.
It will take place because people who are sick, they will be healed.
교회가 살면 여러분 응답 받을 수밖에 없어요.
And if the church is revived, and all the people have no choice but to be revived, this is very important.
아이들의 뜰.
And the courtyard of children.
아이들의 뜰은 세 가지 참고해야 됩니다.
You need to consider three things for the courtyard of children.
놀 수 있는 곳이라야 돼.
It needs a playground.
아이들은 놀 수가 없으면 교회 모이다 딴 데 갑니다. 놀러 갑니다. 끝에는.
And if our children have no place to play in the church, then they will have to go somewhere else.
아이들 딴 데 갔다 교회 와서 놀 수 있어야 돼요.
When other people are children are playing somewhere else, they should be able to come to our church to play and rest.
그리고 배울 수 있어요.
And learn.
여러분 이 축복을 받게 됩니다.
And you will receive this answer and blessing.
드디어 뭡니까?
And ultimately,
여러분의 업은
your
세계 복음하는 로마서 16장에 비밀 결사대로 서게 됩니다.
We will be established as a secret squad, just like Romans chapter 16 for world evangelization.
여러분의 업은
and your occupation
렘넌트를 키우는 RM의 산실이 되는 겁니다.
Will become the very reality of remnant ministry of saving the remnants.
자, 이때부터 하나님 여러분 축복하셔서
and because God will continue to bless you.
성전 중요합니다. Holy Mission의 주역이 되는 거예요.
The temple is so important. That's why you become the main figures of the Holy Mission.
역사도 그렇게 됐습니다.
And that was the case for all the remnants.
우리 중위자들이 응답으로 붙잡으셔.
And that's why all of your church officers need to hold on to it as your covenant and answer.
어떻게 하면 됩니까?
You may ask, what shall I do? It's very simple. Just do 24 hours.
기도 24 하면 반드시 25 와요.
If you do 24 hours of prayer, 25 answer will come. That is the standard.
목표는 뭡니까?
What is our goal?
영원입니다.
Eternity.
여러분이 하는 일은 해도 되고 안 하는 일을 왜 합니까?
아니죠? If you need to do something that you should not really do necessarily, why would you do it? Rather, you need to do something that would leave behind
아니,
this everlasting answer.
좋고, 안 해도 되고, 허위를 합니까?
Why do you do 거고? Anything that something that is not necessarily needs to be done?
예수님께서 거짓말을 하기 위해서 십자가 가지고 처형당합니까? 아니죠.
Did Jesus die on the cross and get
perjured? 꼭 있어야 되기 때문에 그걸 전달해요.
For no reason? No, he died because that had to be done.
이 축복을 누려야 돼요.
And that's why you need to relay this blessing.
야손, 중요합니다.
Acts 17:6, Jason, very important.
왜 중요합니까?
Why is it so important?
그때.
At the time.
그때입니다.
It's that time.
하나님이 필요로 하시는 때.
The time that God needs.
있는 중이자예요.
You are the church officer who
그렇죠?
remain inside of that time.
보세요.
And think about this.
시간표입니다.
It is time schedule.
그곳에.
That place.
그 사건입니다.
That incident.
속에 있는 사람이에요.
And you are a person inside of this.
하나님께서 애굽을 살리려고 보냈지만 이제는 이 사람이 좀 나와야 돼요.
God did send Israelites to save Egypt, but now is the time for them to come out from Egypt.
그때에
at that time, So those who held onto that covenant that time. Let me introduce you two individuals. Moses' mother, Exodus 2, 1 through 10. It had no choice but to take place. Also, process of Rahab. Time schedule is very important. Joshua 2, verses 1 through 16. Acts 1, 1 through 14. It's inevitable, had no choice but to take place. Where? Also, that place is important. Time schedule is important. And what about that place? It's not anything different.
하나님이 행하시려고 하는 제자를 예비해 둔 곳.
It is a place where God has prepared His disciple, and being used for that is that place.
그곳.
It is that place where God prepared His disciples.
일이죠.
This is amazing.
귀한 목사님들이 외국 가고 네팔 가고 어디 가서요? 그게 하나님이 예비한 사람 만났단 말이에요.
And God sends our pastors into all these foreign places, and then they go to Nepal and then find the disciples that God prepared. There's no greater blessing than that.
이상하게 헤엄을 못 치겠더라고요.
So strangely, when I was young, I could not swim. There's a reason for it.
어릴 때부터 우리 어머니가 물에 대한 협박을 늘 한 거예요.
And my mother just threatened me so much about the danger of water. And I do understand.
우리 집 앞이 부두니까 그냥 바닷가 아니에요. 부두에 그 빠지면 죽어요.
And we had a harbor right in front of our house. It's actually quite dangerous if we just plunge into the water.
물에 빠지면 죽는 얘기만 하는 거예요.
That's why whenever she had a chance, she would tell me about, you know, how we die when we just fall into the water.
물에서 몸이 굳어서 헤엄도 안 돼요.
That's why I would just freeze when I just go into the water. I could not even swim.
근데 이게 말이죠. 어느 날 내가 어릴 때 산 동네 우리 살 때 부두가에서 불이 나가 산에 올라왔단 말이에요.
And there was a fire that broke out in the harbor area. That's why we had to all relocate to the top of the mountain.
진짜 뭐가 뒤집었지. 내가 그 평소 때 연못이 있어요.
And somehow,
아이들 헤엄치고 놀고 이러거든요.
I saw these children, they're gathering by the pond and they're all swimming.
들어가 보고 싶은 거라.
Somehow I had this urge to go into that water.
그때가 여름이 아니고 좀 지났는데 아이 들어가는데 내가 그냥 순간적으로 빠지는 거예요.
And I just went into that pond, and all of a sudden my body froze, and I just drowned.
그때 무슨 느낌이 딱 드나면은 이제 물이 탁 냄새나는 걸 느끼고요.
And immediately I was able to smell the water.
그래 살라고 자꾸 찾잖아요. 그렇게 싹 보이다 또 내려가고.
And because I want to survive, I wanted to come out of the water, and my head would go out into the surface of the water.
그때 드는 생각이 아 이래 죽는구나 이런 생각이 들더라고.
And the second thought was that oh maybe that's how I will die. When I was young.
근데 그 장소가 사람이 다니는 데가 아니에요.
But that area of the pond was not some place where people would travel.
되는데 안 다니니까 모르잖아요.
It's a remote area. People would not pass by.
그러고 있는데 내가 누가 와서 나를 건져주는 겁니다.
However, somebody came by and then rescued me out.
예, 그때 그 장소에 어떻게 그 사람이 지나갔겠어요?
So how on earth that there was this man that passed by in that very precise moment?
이분 한 번 느껴도 그 끝난 거란 말이에요.
In that decisive moment, even if he was late a minute or two, I would have died.
천사가 나타난 거지. 갑자기 사람이 나를 건져주는데 내가 그때 막 뭐가 올라오고 이러더라고요.
And really, it was an angel that God sent. And that man, he rescued me out, and I had to throw up all my water, vomit out water.
가더라고, 사람.
And after, you know, knowing that I was okay, he left.
그게 한 초등학교 3학년 때인가 4학년 때 그랬어.
I think I was in third or fourth grade in elementary school.
그 기억이 내가 늘 나거든.
I always remember that moment.
지금 생각해도 야, 또 그때 그 사람 지나갔지.
And I always wonder how is that that man passed by in that moment.
그보다 더 중요한요. 하나님이 제자를 예비해 놓고 여러분을 보내셨는데 이 중직에 쓰임 받은
And much more importantly, that God prepares the disciples and sends you there. And all of you, church officers, are those people who would seek out these disciples. You are the people of Romans chapter 16.
무슨 사건입니까?
And what kind of incident is this?
그냥 복음 전했다 이렇게 말하면 되겠지만 무슨 사건입니까?
You can just say, okay, I evangelized, share the gospel. But what is this specific incident?
영세전에 감추던 거.
Romans 16:25. What was hidden for long ages past?
지금 아니면 안 되는 거. 지금 감추.
What is now disclosed?
미래 영원히 있을 것.
And the future. What will be forever and ever? Forever and more. That's what God has given to you.
내가 쓰임 받는 거. 이거는 충격적인 일입니다.
And
그렇죠?
being used for that ministry and is more than shocking.
병들어서 말이죠. 너무 위험해서 고난당해 죽는 사람들 얼마나 많은데 우리를 하나님이 부르셔서 이 일을 하도록 부르셨다.
And there are so many people right in this moment many people are dying away because of their illness but God has called us into this great tremendous ministry. All of you church officers.
24대기를 주 예수 이름으로 축복합니다.
I bless you in the Lord Jesus Christ and may you enjoy this 24 hours through prayer.
그럼 여러분 산업에 25 올 겁니다.
Then 25 hours answers will come to your
여러분이
business.
여러분이 이 땅을 떠나고 하나님 앞에 갔을 때 영원한 작품이 남게 될 겁니다.
And the day when you leave this earth and return to Christ,
기도하겠습니다.
then you will leave down the
감사드립니다.
eternal masterpiece. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you.
중직자들 복음 때문에 부르심을 감사를 드립니다.
Thank you so much for calling all the church officers throughout the nation and the world
그
for the gospel.
그 시간표에 우리를 부르심을 감사를 드립니다.
Thank you so much for calling us in this time
그
schedule.
그곳에 하나님이 원하시는 그 일에 쓰임 받게 하시니 감사를 드립니다.
In that place, in that work that you desire, thank you so much for allowing us to be
모든
used.
모든 중직자 24, 25 영원의 능력을 누리게 하옵소서.
May all of our church officers enjoy the power of 24 hours, 25 hours, and eternity.
기도하옵나이다.
In our Lord Jesus Christ, 아멘. And we pray, Amen.